Aha, there we are, Dinky Doo. It's just me, Scotty McClue. And we are, of course, live on Facebook Live, the World Stop broadcast platform. Welcome, 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 I say, to 1 hour of superb scintillating information, education, and entertainment with the World Stop broadcaster and first lord of the internet, my good self, Scotty McClue. Dinky Doo to all of you. We have so much to discuss tonight, and I hope you will join me as quickly as possible so that we can get it all talked up. Now, we should be absolutely on time, so there we are. So welcome, welcome, welcome. And I see that everybody is watching. Tremendous. Ah, Paul, Francis Carroll, and Andrew Mackay, good evening. Andy Drummond, Dinky Doo to all of you, and a very big thank you to you for joining us. Paul Newman's here, Robert Devlin, of course, Paul Goodyear. How tremendous. You are all coming and joining us. So much to discuss tonight. And as ever, so little time to do it in. So I hope we can get started as quickly as possible. Several subjects for discussion. Danny Cotting, the head of the London Fire Brigade, is suggesting that Fireman Sam, it could actually be a bit stereotypical, and that it should be a firefighter Sam. So there you are. So I was just wondering, you know, when will it be Thunder Blokes or Go? Or something like that. But do tell us what you think about this. Do you think political correctness is a little bit over the top sometimes, and it's been pushed by one side without necessarily proper reference to the other side? I mean, does that mean instead of saying our Father God, we say our Mother Goddess? You know, where do you stop with this sort of thing? So there you are. So tell us what you think. Very, very interested in your points. So that's the head of the London Fire Brigade. Hi, Scotty from Dublin, says Gordon Ritchie. Dinky Doo. Hello to everybody in Dublin, Gordon. Lovely to have you with us, of course, as always. If you've just joined us, folks, it's me, it's Scotty McClue, and we're live on the big one. We're live on Facebook Live for 1 hour. 1 hour of superb scintillating information, education, and entertainment. Dinky Doo, looking brand new, my man, says Dave Rindle. I thank you, Dave. Dinky Doo, lovely to be with you all. Irene Waddles there, of course, Craig Nicol, and firefighters, they should be called, says Robert Devlin, not firemen. Firefighters, because we've got a few ladies in there. Andrew Spexman's watching. Dinky Doo, Andrew, thank you very much. Thank you for your kind comments and for setting up a page. There we are. That's excellent, as you say. The more, the merrier. Alfred James Wright's watching. Andre, Elizabeth, Lucy McLaughlin's watching from the United States of America. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Tell us your story, where you grew up and how you get into this, says John Pollock. John, there's so many interviews. If you go on and hear the interview with Scotty McClue with Shelley McRobbie from Radio Telstar International just about 10 days ago, and you'll see that on Scotty McClue's Facebook page. So put that in, the interview with Shelley McRobbie, Radio Telstar International, RTI, and Scotty McClue on their stuff. There's LBC just telling us that they've gone live. That's the way. Yes, imitation is the sincerest form of flattery, I always say. Ian Hornby's watching. Dinky Doo, Andrew Thompson, Billy Andrew, the spiritual medium, is watching. How marvellous is that? We'll maybe get a chat with you at some time, Billy. Katie Booth's watching. And Soran Arif has joined us as well. Soran Arif. Finlay Patterson. Hi, I'm watching. You're an inspiration with the posting and content. Thank you, and I hope you have a wonderful week, says Andrea Elizabeth Lucy McLaughlin in the United States of America. So there we are. Had I, of course, been an American citizen, you may have had President McClue, and I could have gone out there and said, my fellow Americans, this is for all of you. I would have looked upon my role, of course, as curatorial. So there we are. Scotty, why do you like your own comments on Facebook, says Johnny Emlini. Well, I used to be a bit concerned that there wasn't a love button, Johnny, so we had to just like them. But now there's a love button. You can love your comments as well. And it's interesting that some people get a bit upset. Everybody should be able to do that, and everybody should be doing it. So follow suit rather than be mystified. That's it. Follow suit, I say, because why would you make a comment if you don't like it? You see what I'm saying? What do you make of Big Ben being done up with steel from other countries, says Angie Thompson. Well, of course, since we got rid of British steel, Margaret Thatcher, I think, could take the full brunt of responsibility for that. We've had to search for steel from elsewhere. There is an amount of British steel, but it's not endless, of course, and people are always looking at the price. But what I would say to British companies is, look, see if you can do it for us at that price and you've got the job. We certainly shan't be going anywhere else, although we are a global world now. Mike Henfield, one of the finest broadcast managers and one of the greatest journalists in this country today, is watching. Dinky do to you, Mike Henfield, the man who got me into all this in the first place. Alan Stitt's watching. Davy Diamond, hi, John. Councillor Henry Anderson, dinky do. Lovely to have you all with us. Now, many subjects for discussion tonight, guys, so see if you can get down to that. We're talking about Danny Cotton, the head of the London Fire Brigade, as saying that she thinks that Fireman Sam should be Firefighter Sam. Does this start the way for Thomas Aina and Gerina? Does this start the way for Andrea Pandy? That sort of idea. The flower pot people, you know, because we don't know, they could be of all sorts of origin. Should we be looking at that? I say. Hi, Scott, this is John Robertson. Hello. What do you think of the EU asking for 100 billion before we've even talked about Brexit? Well, what I think we're needing to do there is say to the Prime Minister, just cancel Brexit. You're arguing for what we already have in abundance. What's the point in that? So it's not Turkey's voting for Christmas as we had in the EU referendum. It's Turkey's now saying we'll pay for Christmas as well, and we'll pay to get ourselves into the shops. You know, that's what we're effectively saying. Donald Drake says, Eddie Dobie Senior, yes. Donald Drake? Well, no, it might. You see, well, this is a moot point. You see, is it Donald Drake? Because that's him saying that he's definitely a guy. Bring back Margaret Thatcher, I say, says Davy Diamond. Davy Diamond, I suggest you qualify what you thought was so attractive about Margaret Thatcher, because what she did was, as it stripped Scotland, as it stripped the rest of the country and took all the money down to London so that it would go into property and finance. That's what she did. So we owed a lot of money from there. I was watching your call-in the other day. You're hilarious, says Kamal Aziz. I thank you, Kamal. Good evening, Scotty, from the Dunhamer. Robert Rogerson, Dun in Dumfries there, the Dunhamer. He's a Dunhamer. Fantastic stuff. Margaret Thatcher is an idiot, says Tricia McLear. So there you are. Well, she's gone now. She's not here to defend herself. But, you know, I think that she was far from an idiot, but she was a great asset stripper. And, of course, that's why we've got no shipbuilding on the River Clyde now. Very little shipbuilding, shall I say. There should be a lot more. We've got some good shipbuilding, but we need a lot more. Tiga Alatha, Scotty, a little lesson in Gaelic for you. Ah, Koashin, Kamrahau Hakama, Hakamache. There you are, a little lesson in Gaelic for you. Stephen Wright, what? He says, Scotty, can we ban taxi drivers from the show? They're a disgrace with their dangerous driving and expensive charges for poor service, says Gordon Stirling. Now, there's a man who knows about transport. He understands about transport. Would you say taxi drivers give poor service and are too expensive? Drew McKenzie's watching. Dinky Doo. Brexit is Fireman Sam's fault, says Robert Difflin. So they are very, very interesting, Robert, I say. But all I can say is it looks like Brexit is heading for disaster. I mean, very, very heavily, the government, including the Prime Minister, were very much against Brexit. And then when that referendum came up with a couple of pluses on it, they then started saying, and this is what's so wrong about mainstream media, because they say things like, Britain has voted to come out. Britain hasn't voted to come out. just over half have voted. Scotland did not vote against independence. Just over half voted against independence. Do you see what I mean? And there was a tremendous push from mainstream media to get people's hearts, minds and brains taken over, tell them anything as long as they didn't vote for an independent Scotland, because obviously the money would be missed by Westminster. It's the council that sets the fare, Scotty, not the taxi drivers, says Stephen Wright. So there you are. There you're all informed now, you see. We inform, educate and entertain on the Scotty McClure Show. We are live, we are global, worldwide right now. Dinky-doo. Will Brexit cost the Tories another election, in your opinion? Says Robert Devlin. Well, the only trouble is people are not all welcoming Labour with open hands. I mean, Labour in Scotland is just kicked into the long grass. They are wandering about in the jungle and probably will be forever and a day. Now, the reason that Labour are not popular in Scotland is they betrayed the people. They betrayed their Labour roots, and they went with the union when they should have gone with independence, because that's what's best for Scotland economically. So there we are. So I'm afraid Labour should have changed. In fact, I can tell you right now, had the Labour leader in Scotland just gone her own way at the time and said, sorry, Westminster, but we're going with the independence thing, Labour would probably be in power in Scotland now. That's